So this is Clear for Takeoff, Chapter 1, Part 2. We're just reading here, exploring the airplane you'll fly. So we read this in a previous video, and we left off here with the sign out. Legends and lore. And on top of the side of here. So let's just read that in and continue reading. I'm not sure if I read the fuse lodge, but we'll read the whole page. We start with the side note. So let's read the side note here. High, low, mid, or canard, I don't know what canard is. All kinds of wings have been hung on fuselages since the beginnings of flight. Which is best? Well, it's a tad like a driver's loyalty to Ford, Chevy, or Yugo. I don't know the brand Yugo. Which type you prefer often depends on which you first drove, or in the case of the Yugo, push. This is a pushing car, the Yugo. Anyways, let's keep reading here. 1-1-2. I don't know if you can see it. My phone. On my screen, it's not too bright. So, fuselage. The fuselage is the body of the airplane attached to it. It's the body of the airplane. Attached to it, you'll find the propeller and engine, the wings, the landing gear, and the tail. So, the fuselage is the body of the airplane. The fuselage is where you'll load your passengers and their luggage. It contains the seats, the baggage compartment, and the flight controls, plus all the instruments, avionics, and gags. Don't know what games are. Propeller. The propeller or prop pulls the airplane through the air, turning clockwise as you watch it from your seat. So counterclockwise from your side. That's interesting. The engine. The engine is attached to the front of the fuselage and provides the power to move the airplane through the air by turning the propeller. The engine also drives the accessories like the alternator, magnetos, and vacuum pump. Magnetos and vacuum pump. Does it use a vacuum pump of a sort for propelling the airplane? I don't know. Your Skyhawk is equipped with, or maybe it just has a built-in vacuum. Your Skyhawk is the plane you're learning to fly. This plane here. Your Skyhawk is equipped with a normally aspirated direct drive, air-cooled, horizontally opposed fuel injected, 160 HP engine. I don't know what HP means. He's just expressing it. More about all that mechanical gobbledygook in a later chapter. I don't know why they make it seem like reading this is so like all these expressions. I don't understand why they would have them. It's almost like they're trying to impress a 4-year-old or something. Because even 4-year-olds don't need all that. They just need straight information. Wings. The wings are attached to the fuselage and create lift perpendicular to their length or span, thus supporting the weight of the airplane as it moves through the air. The fuel tanks are also located in the wings. The Skyhawks wings are located on the top of the fuselage, hence it's called a high wing airplane. The high wing has several advantages. You'll find that the fuel tank sumps are much easier to drain when you're checking fuel samples. You have much better ground clearance from low obstacles. You have an excellent view below and to the sides during loading and unloading. You'll really appreciate the shelter the wings provide when it's raining. You'll also discover that the wing provides shade from the sun, both on the ground and in the air. You can even hang sheets from it and make a tent if you're camping or when there's no room at the inn. So that's it for that page. Let's read 1-3, the next page. And let's read the sign-ups first before landing here. Sign-ups. Legends and lore. Okay, most modern airplanes employ tricycle gear. In conventional gear airplanes, the main wheels are forward and the steerable wheel are making it a tail wheel, hence the name tail driver. Wheel aft. I don't know what happened. Making it a tail wheel, hence the name tail driver. Let's read that again. Most modern airplanes employ tricycle gear. In conventional gear airplanes, the main wheels are forward and the steerable wheel aft. I have to look that up. Making it a tail wheel, hence the name tail driver. Okay, so I guess the sign-offs are just legends and lore, whatever that means. I guess they're just sayings of people pertaining to planes and stuff. Empennage, another French word for means, you guessed it, tail assembly of an airplane. Empennage. Well, actually, it's derived from empennage, which means to feather an arrow. Empennage. To feather an arrow. Okay, well, let's keep reading. Landing gear. 1-3, landing gear. Landing gear. The landing gear or gear is another important assembly attached to the fuselage. The Skyhawk has what is known as tricycle landing gear, so named because it looks and behaves like a child's tricycle. Let me just read this again. Landing gear. The landing gear or gear is another important assembly attached to the fuselage. The Skyhawk has what is known as tricycle landing gear, so named because it looks and behaves like a child's tricycle. One wheel in front called the nose wheel and two main wheels behind it and under the fuselage arranged like a triangle. The nose wheel steers the airplane on the ground and supports the nose and the engine. The nose wheel does not have a brake. It's not as strong as either the main wheels and is incapable of supporting the full weight of the airplane, which is why you might watch your instructor rip his or her hair out in chunks should you ever land on your nose wheel first. Okay, kid. This is absolutely not necessary the way you would describe it. You could have just said, be careful with the landing because it's very dangerous or something. Anyways, keep going. The nose wheel is connected via springs to the rudder paddles in the cockpit. That's very interesting because there's only four seats, the pilot, co-pilot, and passengers. So that's kind of funny. Push the left rudder pedal and the nose wheel turns to the left. Pushing the right rudder paddle turns the nose wheel to the right. Pushing the right rudder paddle turns the nose wheel to the right. The nose wheel is connected via springs to the rudder paddle in the cockpit. I don't see any picture for the rudder paddle. This did come with a DVD, but I tried watching it and I couldn't get any visual on the screen. The nose wheel is connected via springs to the rudder paddles in the cockpit. Push the left rudder paddle and the nose wheel turns to the left. Okay, so pushing the right rudder paddle turns the nose wheel to the right. So the rudder paddles control the nose wheel. Whatever those are, when you'll find them someday if you ever get one of those things, because I don't know where they are here in the picture. There's no picture story. Rudder. The nose wheel is connected via springs to the rudder paddles. So there's one to the left to turn the left and one to the right to turn the right. I guess it's not a big deal because you're taking off basically at that point and you're turning the plane just to take off, park it. So it's not really a big deal that you have to use both hands for it. Not too much coordination needed for the speed that you're traveling in at that point. So pushing the right rudder paddle turns the nose wheel to the right. So I guess it's not like you have to know where they are exactly. You just kind of look to your left and your right and you kind of find out where they are. Now we have here where it keeps going. The two main wheels are designed to carry the full weight of the airplane by themselves. They are normally the last two. They are normally the last to leave the ground during takeoff and the first to touch during landing. That is, if you want your instructor to retain most of his hair, the brakes are attached to the main wheels, and you control each one individually by pushing on the top of them. If you need to make a tight turn, first apply full rudder, then brake in the same direction, and the airplane will pivot around that wheel. A good thing to be able to do in tight parking spots. I gotta read that again. Okay, well, let's think about it. The two main wheels are designed to carry the full weight of the airplane by themselves. They are normally the last to leave the ground during takeoff and the first to touch during landing. So when landing, your main objective is to land very smoothly on the back wheels first, slowly, but you're not in a incredible angle per se. You're looking to land the plane very straight, but you're not landing on the front wheels first. So it's just slightly angled, but not too much. So where you have to have control for the balance of the nose to actually be there to catch him. As a forward motion. Let's see here. The two main wheels are designed to carry the full weight of the airplane by themselves. They are normally the last to leave the ground during takeoff and the first to touch during landing. That is, if you want your instructor to retain most of his or her hair. Right, what do you mean? Let's see if I understand this kind of thing, because this is very insignificant to me. The two main wheels are designed to carry the full weight of the airplane by themselves. They are normally the last to leave the ground during takeoff and the first to touch during landing. Okay, so they're telling you if you care about your instructor, then you're going to do it right. So the brakes are attached to the main wheels, the back wheels, and you control each one individually by pushing on the top of them. So there's probably a left and right brake as well for the left and right wheels separately. If you need to make a tight turn, first apply full rudder, meaning the left or right rudder where the nose wheel is attached to, where it says here, the nose wheel is connected via springs to the rudder pedals in the cockpit. So the left rudder pedal moves the nose and the nose wheel turns to the left. It says push the left rudder pedal, so you push. Here it says the brakes are attached to the main wheels, and you control each wheel individually by pushing on the top of it. If you need to make a tight turn, first apply full rudder. That's the rudder pedal. Apply full rudder in the direction you're going, left or right. Then brake in the same direction. What does this mean? Let me see. This is to make a sharp turn or something. The brakes The brakes are attached to the main wheels, and you control each one individually by pushing on the tap pedal. If you need to make a tight turn, so this is when you're either taking off or parking, and you gotta turn around to catch speed on your takeoff. First, apply full rudder to the front wheel in the direction in which you're turning to, then brake in the same direction. Okay, so if I'm going left, I brake well, the left wheel as well. And the airplane will pivot around that wheel. What does this mean? That's a sharp turn. That means you're probably going a little bit too fast. Pivot, I don't know what that means, but I'm guessing it just does, that's the, because it's going fast, it kind of turns in the direction, but I don't know where the left wheel stops and the rudder is turning to the front, to the left. Then there's a, okay, it's a sharp turn. Okay, individually by pushing on the top of that. If you need to make a tight turn, first apply full rudder, then brake in the same direction, and the airplane will pivot around that wheel. A good thing to be able to do in tight parking spots. It'll just stop where it is and at the same time, but you turn the rudder, and at the same time you brake the left wheel. It says by pushing on the top of them, that's how you brake individually each wheel. Okay, so let's read here, continue on tail. We're almost there, kid. Tail. Finally, we arrive at the tail. Or if you really want to impress the folks around the airport, call it the empennage. This is where the vertical stabilizer and rudder and horizontal stabilizer and elevator are attached to the fuselage. And finally, we arrive at the tail. Or if you really want to impress the folks around the airport, call it the empennage. This is where, we're talking about the tail. This is where our empennage, tail or empennage. This is where the vertical stabilizer and rudder and tail. The vertical stabilizer and rudder. I don't know what the stabilizer is yet, or if they're going to talk about it. The vertical stabilizer and rudder. Let's see here. Anyways, so the vertical stabilizer and rudder, the rudder. To the rudder pedals, via springs to the rudder pedals. Okay, the vertical stabilizer and rudder. It's in the empennage, the tail. And horizontal stabilizer and elevator. So these things we haven't learned yet, the horizontal stabilizer and elevator. Elevator's coming up soon. It's in the tail in the depiction. You can see figure 1-2. And you can see clearly what they're showing the tail here. And they're showing the elevator on the left tail here. So The empennage of the tail, this is where the vertical stabilizer and rudder and horizontal stabilizer. So both vertical and horizontal stabilizers are in the tail. And elevator are attached to the fuselage. So the fuselage is the body of the Skyhawk, of the plane. Skyhawk is just the name that plane has. And this is kind of the particular plane we're learning about. It's about 4 seats. So this is vertical and horizontal stabilizer. And rudder are there in the tail. And so is the elevator, which you will learn soon about. And attached to the fuselage of the body. So the vertical stabilizer doesn't move, acting like the flight of a dart. Okay, the tail feathers. We call it the tail feathers. Let's see, the vertical stabilizer. The vertical stabilizer doesn't move. The tail feathers. Vertical stabilizer. Okay. So out of the three, what you see here, but in the back, the vertical, that one doesn't move, that's the stabilizer, vertical stabilizer. And the horizontal stabilizer, I'm assuming it does move just a bit. So the vertical stabilizer doesn't move, acting like the flight of a dart. It helps keep the airplane straight during normal flight. You might also think of it as behaving like a weather vane attached to the rear of the vertical stabilizer. Is the rudder. Okay, so I don't know what a weather vane is, but attached to the vertical stabilizer, which is the tail that doesn't move, the one facing upward, that's just, I guess, to keep aerodynamics in check, that doesn't move. You may think of it as behaving like a weather vane attached to the rear of the vertical stabilizer is the rudder. Or where you control the front wheel from. You might think of it as behaving like a weather vane. I don't know why they do this. Maybe I guess I have to learn what a weather vane is. But I don't really understand. What was it that I was comparing it to? To keep the aerodynamics in check. So I guess this is better. Let's see. Acting like the flight of a dart. It helps. Nothing to do with a dart. Dart probably moves out. It helps keep, I think darts rotate, for sure. I think I'm almost pretty sure, 100%. It helps keep the airplane straight during normal flight. Yeah, darts don't stay straight. You might also think of it as, I don't understand why you think, as a weather vane. Anyways, attached to the rear of the vertical stabilizer is the rudder. Remember, the rudder is what controls the front wheel. The rudder pedal via springs to the rudder. The rudder is what controls the pedals in the cockpit to move the front wheel. I think that's almost describing the prop. Attached to the rear of the vertical stabilizer is the rudder, which you will employ to help make smooth, coordinated turns. On many planes, like the Skyhawk, we're now reading on the next page, the 1-4. I think that's the way these pages are numbered. I think one for the chapter, and then it changes all the way up to 1921, all the way up to 21, chapter 21. This is quite a bit on this plane. So, 1-5. I might start titling the videos 1-5 and things like that. Part 2, 1-1-4. Maybe not, because we're going through different pages. So 1-2, 1-3, 1-4. So it's quite a bit. So in parts, I'll do it. Anyways, on many planes like the Skyhawk, the horizontal stabilizer, this is the actual second part of the tail, the one that moves. As you can see right there. The one is a circle. Hopefully you can see on your screen. So the vertical rudder doesn't move, and then the one to the left and the one to the left and the right. That one, those move. It's really on it. On many planes, like the Skyhawk, the horizontal stabilizer is part of the structure and doesn't move. On many planes, the horizontal stabilizer, this one doesn't move anyway. I thought it did. Well, okay, so there's two parts to it. I think that's what we're going to read. The elevator is the other part, maybe, I don't know. The horizontal stabilizer is part of the structure and doesn't move. And like the vertical stabilizer, behaves like the tail feathers of a dart. And then I don't think that's a good analogy, but who cares? Resisting unwanted up or down movement. The elevator attaches to the rear of the horizontal stabilizer and helps control the airplane's pitch or the nose's up and down movement. Okay, so the elevator is the only thing is attached to the horizontal stabilizer. So I mean, that's what I was thinking, but I didn't know they were separated from the horizontal stabilizer. I thought it was just since it's attached, this part doesn't move, but this part does. I thought it would just be part of the same thing. With an attachment, but I mean, I guess the attachment is the elevator. So that's pretty cool. That's pretty good, actually. The elevator attaches to the rear of the horizontal stabilizer and helps control the airplane's pitch or the nose's up and down movement. So, I guess that's how you control the plane from going up or down. That's when you use the elevator to either, or maybe not exactly. I guess it's just to keep it steady in flight, maybe. The parts on the wing and tail that move. Now, let's take a look at the parts that move, those parts that let you control the airplane in flight. The elevator first comes the elevator, which is attached to the horizontal stabilizer via hinges. The elevator controls the nose up or nose down position. Because if you want to go a little bit higher, you control the elevator position too. That's interesting. First comes the elevator, which is attached to the horizontal stabilizer via hinges. The elevator controls the nose up or down. Up or nose down position of the airplane, also known as attitude, and moving the nose up or down as you move the control wheel back and forth. Control back and forth. My God, that's how you move the whole plane with the control. The control wheel back and forth. It's called pitching. Pitching can be used in many contexts. Baseball, music, pop tents. I don't know what pop tents are. Whoa, I don't know. Or that black goo you start all over your pants when you're patching the roof. But here it's used in the nautical one, the rising and falling off the bow of a ship. If you want to pitch the airplane so the nose will go up, you pull back on the control wheel, rising the elevator into the wind. The up elevator creates an aerodynamic force. If you want to pitch the airplane so the nose will go up, you pull back on the control wheel. If you want to pitch the airplane so the nose will go up, you pull back on the control wheel, raising the elevator into the wind. That is crazy. I don't understand how the aerodynamics on that. I don't even know how that would even work, but it works. Into the wind, the up elevator creates an aerodynamic force that moves the tail of the airplane down. Okay, that's how that works. So it's not moving the nose, it's moving the tail downward, therefore creating upward motion of the nose, which has a propeller and is moving the airplane upward. That is crazy. Because the elevator is not a propeller, so there's no controversy on propelling forces. That's very interesting. Okay, so it moves the tail of the airplane down and the nose up. To pitch the nose back down again, you will push the controller wheel forward, which lowers the elevator into the wind and raises the tail. So it's all about raising or lowering the tail in order to control the entire plane. It's very interesting. Okay. Right, ailerons. So ailerons. So here's another thing. The plane has wings. Not just tail. The tail is a. So it has slightly two wings per se, the main wings in the front and the back wings, which I call the tail. And the tail has the elevators to control the nose up or down. And the front wings, the actual wings on the plane, just their wings, because they're longer, and the tail is not shorter, so it has its name for a reason. And so there's actually sorts of elevators on the wings also. So that's very interesting. I know you've seen it when you been in commercial flights. You sit by the wings. You can see there's a flapping thing. And those are probably the front elevators, but they're called ailerons. Ailerons. They're called ailerons. See, airplane rolls right aileron up, left aileron down. Airplane rolls right, left aileron down, right aileron up. That's crazy. I wonder where those controllers are. Let's see, figure 1-3. We're on page 1-5. Figure 1-3. I guess they have their own order. The ailerons control the banking of the airplane and work opposite each other. Opposite to each other. Okay. The ailerons control the banking of the airplane. The banking. I don't know what that means. And work opposite to each other. Turning the control wheel to the left raises. Oh, okay, so you the airplane rolls right. The ailerons, both left and right ailerons, which are the similar to the airplanes in the tail, I mean to the elevators in the tail. So the elevator in the tail controls the plane up or down with the steering wheel. And what's it called? Steering wheel? Let me go see what it is. That one is called just the wheel. I mean, I guess it's just a wheel, but I think I read something that said called it something. Main wheel to the main wheels. Anyways, I'll call the steering wheel until I find what it's called, 'cause I don't know. So, but I know it wasn't a steering wheel. Well, it might have been, but I doubt it. Let's see. So, you pull back, and I'm tired of that. Anyways, we tried it. Let's see. The ailerons control the banking of the airplane and work opposite each other. Turning the control wheel to the left rises the left aileron, lowers the right aileron, okay, simultaneously, and causes the plane to back to the left.